Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to NehaTripathiTalkShow. Talk Show. We are running a very special city tour with women entrepreneurs for the month of March. Going ahead also, we'll be doing a special tour with women. But this month, especially to break the myth that women do not have role models in the sector they work in. We strongly believe that women have been role model for themselves, and if we do not find the role models in the immediate sector or the hierarchy, if we look around, we have enough role models to learn from. And yes, social media is one tool we can learn. And here is one source of medium through which I'm trying to interact with as many women entrepreneurs and understand their performance, their mindset in the business that they have grown in. And here is with us a very special guest with us, Chanchal. She's running her own brand by the name of her name, Chanchal. And it's a very beautiful brand. We will talk about it later. We will also see some of her products. And she's trying to create this art and bringing in more life to the art and creativity. Hello, Chanchal. Welcome to our show.
Thank you so much, Neha. Hello, everyone. Hi, Neha. Thank you for having me.
So, Chanchal, talk about your brand. What does your brand do? And why did you start this business altogether?
All right. So, our brand is called Chanchal, bringing art to life. And what we are trying to achieve through this brand is we are trying to promote and revive traditional Indian art and textiles and create contemporary products using the same. So we make contemporary handbags, which include laptop bags, wallets, tote bags, duffel bags, and variety of bags that a woman and a lot of men can use. And we also do variety of everyday accessories, including sunglass cases, jewelry, handcrafted journals. And we have very recently also launched our sari collection. So the idea is to keep promoting the various weaves of the country and create things which are extremely contemporary and extremely modern.
Right. So before we go ahead with this entrepreneurial journey, let's go a step back. So before entering into this business, what were you doing?
So it's interesting. I come from a very different background. I was working with research and consulting domain for almost a decade. The last job that I held was in a research company where I was heading the financial research and the business research part of the company. So extremely different than what I'm doing today. I think the shift has been so drastic for me and for everybody around me, but it's been such an interesting and very enriching journey. So that's what I was doing earlier. I'm not from a design background. I've studied MBA from a college in Delhi University, not Delhi University, from Delhi. So that's what my background is, a very different background from what I do today.
Okay. So while you were in the corporate journey and this transition into running your own business, what was that thought? Did it come to you when you were right in the corporate sector, or you were going through some break, then this idea popped up? So this transition entirely, how did that happen? And how was this journey when you just began your business?
Okay. I'll go a little back. I created my first business plan when I was in my third year of college. And entrepreneurship was something that really fascinated me. When I made my first business plan, I was not in the position to actually start that business. But the
and
idea.
What was that business plan?
That's not something that I'm doing today. I wanted to open a book cafe. I love to read. And back at that time, when I was in college, there were no such spaces where somebody could read, which is not a library, where people can go sit in peace, read their books, and can also have a cup of tea. So the idea was to mix and match these two ideas and create something which is extremely comfortable for a reader. So far, I have not been able to do that, but that idea is with me, and hopefully somewhere in future, I will go back to that idea as well. But coming back to the idea that I'm currently working upon, I have been an extreme admirer of Indian textile and art. I have traveled across the country in various villages and towns and have met with a lot of artisans and weavers. And my meetings with these weavers always left me with a little bit of pain, I would say, because knowing how rich we are in tradition, yet these kind of art forms have not been able to make into the modern markets. So that idea was always there. So when I got the opportunity to start something of my own, I went back to that idea. I brainstormed on that. I did a lot of travel, again went back to these villages, met so many of artisans and weavers, and that's how the journey of Chanchal began. The foundation of Chanchal was laid in all these villages and towns with these beautiful artists and lovely human beings who were creating such intricate art forms.
So before you started Chanchal as a brand, you spent how much time doing the research, or you just went into it?
Since I'm somebody who comes from the research and consulting background, I used all my knowledge from that domain, and I spent almost about 8 to 10 months in traveling to all these villages. I was reading about them definitely, but I realized that reading is not enough when you are doing something which is so core to our tradition, so core to our culture. So for almost 7 to 8 months, I was traveling to different parts of the country. I went to Jharkhand, I went to Odisha, I went to Gujarat, Rajasthan, of course, Tamil Nadu, some parts of Karnataka. So a lot of traveling and a lot of meeting. And after all those meetings, there was this moment when I realized that this needs to be all tied up, and we need to create something which talks to the urban market. So that's how it all came together.
Okay, my assumption, is it right or wrong that you quit your job and then you started traveling, doing your research, and then you launched? Is it right?
Absolutely. Okay. So I quit my job in early 2014. And that's when I was moving from Delhi to Bangalore. I am basically from Delhi. So there was a switch that was happening in the city that I live in. I was getting married and I was coming to Bangalore. So I quit my job before moving to Bangalore. And in about that, those couple of months which I had from getting married to shifting to Bangalore, I did have some time with me. And I also gave myself almost a month of time to settle into this new city. And like any corporate person, I had thought that from Delhi, when I move to Bangalore, I will again probably pick up another job. But I realized when I had some time in my hand, and this was probably the first time in almost a decade where I did not have anything to do and there was no office to go to. So there was almost a month where I was thinking what next. And in that thinking, although there were so many interviews lined up and I was talking to so many corporates, there was something in me that kept telling me that probably this is the time to pause and reflect and go back to the dream that a 21-year-old Chanchal had seen, and why not give it the wings that it needs to be given. So that month was extremely crucial. I had multiple discussions with my husband, with my family. And my husband realized that, yes, there is something that's driving me to do something different. And yeah, this is how it all began. I mean, all those discussions kind of led us to this idea of traveling to various places, talking to artisans, figuring out if this is something that has a market in the, in the city life, in the modern context. And from there, the traveling began. So that's
so,
how it
so when you were having these dialogues, these conversations with your family, your husband, initially, how was that idea picked up? Was that like a surprise? Okay, I'm not doing the job. I have something new to figure out. Was that a surprise, or it was like sunk in slowly? You in some different way? How was that?
It's definitely a surprise, more so because my parents and my siblings, they had always seen me going to work. I started my job right after my college. I just had a month of time after my graduation, and I started my job. And since then, I have been working. I did my MBA while I was, working. And I also did many other, courses and studies. I love to study. So I continued studying while I was working. So they had always seen me doing multiple things, but all of that I was doing with my job. So this time when I told them that I am not going back, it was definitely, it was surprising for them, definitely. I remember my mother telling me that, yes, you can definitely try this. And if you ever want to go back, you can always go back. And I told my mom, maybe, you know, whatever new I pick could be my new journey and could be the new phase of my work life. And I may never want to go back to what I was doing. So she was a little surprised. But when she saw that, you know, I am trying to do something new and this is really giving me a lot of satisfaction, She started to believe in me. And then since then, I have never had any kind of going back thoughts.
Amazing. So your corporate experience and your business experience so far, tell me the difference between both the experiences, how both of them were enriching, because I believe corporate experience doesn't go away. It brings more maturity, it brings a special skill set altogether, and business is completely diverse. It brings different version of you altogether. So how these two made you feel, and how have you created a sync while you are working still today?
That's an interesting one, in fact. I love my job. And unlike a lot of people who say that they hate their job, the 9-to-5 is boring and I don't want to do this or that, I do not believe in that. I thought my job was extremely enriching, and a lot of what I am able to do today is because I could learn it in those years. A decade-long experience, one cannot really let that go, right?
I agree. I totally agree to that.
It is such an enriching time of your life. So I feel one has to make the best out of that. So one of the things that we all learn when we go to corporate is being disciplined. You can't be in a corporate without being disciplined. So that's one thing that I think my work really taught me. In my work role, I was exposed to doing multiple field of tasks. So I was handling a division. When you handle a division, you kind of take care of it as a business of its own, right? You take care of recruitment, you take care of operations, you take care of quality, you take care of clients, you take care of setting up the new team and everything. So I feel that my work gave me the foundation of what I was trying to do with my initial years of Chanchal. And of course, an entrepreneurial journey takes you through a very different path.
Which are right.
Imagine. These are the ways and the path that you as a corporate person would never probably be able to imagine. It's like a huge ground field where you can play whatever you want to play. And that's one thing which I really love about entrepreneurship. It just opens up a different you in front of you. You find a different aspect of your personality and you realize that you can do so much more. You can think so much more and you can imagine so much more. And that's the difference between being in a corporate world and being an entrepreneur. The world is like an open field when you are an entrepreneur. Whereas when you are in corporate, of course, there are objectives, there are visions already set for a company. And you try to make the best out of your capacity and capability to achieve them. So right. That's how I'll say they are different.
So that's one important message for the audience, which I want to share. When you said, you know, corporate journey was completely enriching, I do agree to that. My corporate journey, decade of corporate journey was completely enriching. So what matters as on date today is whatever you are doing, whether you are in a corporate or you're running a business, you just have to love the work that you are doing. It all comes to the bottleneck conclusion that You have to put your heart, mind and soul, even if you're in a job, just put it. Make the best out of it what you are doing and love what you do. And even if you are running a business or if you have plans to run a business, be a little more aware and vigilant. You don't have to quit the business altogether. Do your research, learn a little more, and then go ahead and start your business. But when you are in your business, there's no looking back, no cribbing, no looking back, no victimizing yourself. You are all set. So make up your mind, start, and be where you are. So absolutely. Would you agree with me, Chanchal? Sometimes it happens that, you know, we start being at different places when we are here.
Absolutely. I completely, totally agree with you. I think the grass is always greener on the other side. So when you are on the other side of the table, you always imagine what the side opposite to you looks like. But when you're here, you're never 100% there. So I completely agree with what you said. Whatever you choose, I think there is no comparison. Both have their own pros and cons. And whatever you do, there has to be this inherent willingness to do it wholeheartedly.
Absolutely.
And give your full. And I believe it's not just work. I believe in everything you do, be it personal, be it professional, be it emotional, it has to be done with total sincerity and with total dedication and, of course, a lot of love and passion. And that's when the journey becomes so enriching.
I agree. So, Chanchal, I'm really excited now to see some of your products. Share with us the products, the art, which section you are into. Share with us some of the products and talk about some of the USPs of these products.
Definitely. So before I show you some of the products, just a couple of things that I wanted to give context about. So the way we work is we work with a lot of artisans and weavers, and our journey and our product journeys are extremely collaborative in nature. So we source textile from weavers across the country, Bhagalpur, Jharkhand, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jaipur. You can imagine wherever there are weaving clusters, those are the places where we go and tie up with.
So this is like a huge team that you have.
Absolutely. So when somebody asks me where your team sits, I say, I can't tell you where we sit. We are across the country.
Amazing.
That's what I would like to believe. So I want to take you some of the products which are made of very, very different weaves across the country. So here I am going to start with something extremely beautiful that we did recently for a lot of our customers and especially for Bangalore Literature Festival, and it was a big hit. These are our handcrafted journals. I hope you all are able to see it.
Yes, these are made handcrafted journals.
Right.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, so these are journals. These are basically diaries and or journals where you can write your everyday notes, or if you're a writer, then you always need them. If you're traveling, you need them, right? So the cover of these journals, they are made in hand block textile, which we got made from our artisans who are based out of villages around Jaipur. So this is one of the categories that we do. It's a huge hit among everybody who loves to write. Then we also did something extremely interesting. These are sunglass covers or your spectacle covers. So it has ample space for you to keep your spectacles, sunglasses, or if you want anything which is small or a little trinket. They look extremely beautiful, extremely elegantly made. And these are also a great hit among all the independent
workers. So Chanchal, if someone is not wearing glasses, they can use it as a small, handy makeup kit for themselves.
Absolutely. In fact, this is one thing that I didn't think of, but a lot of our customers come back and say, oh, you know, I'm going to keep my keys in this, or I'm going to keep my lipsticks in this, or I'm going to keep my, you know, little office trinkets in this. So yes, you can always use it. I think creativity comes. If you like something, you'll always find ways to use it. So here is another, category of product that we make. This is a clutch. It's an evening clutch. It's made in a very beautiful kalamkari fabric. Again, this fabric comes from Telangana. There's an artisan cluster who work out of there. And we make this beautiful fabric with them. And then we convert them into beautiful clutches. We recently, because the wedding season is on, we also came up with a wedding clutch collection made in beautiful brocade, hand-woven brocade. And then we combined it with a beautiful green raw silk. They look extremely elegant, extremely classy, and women really love it. And I'm now going to show something which is a work accessory. It's a laptop bag made in a beautiful ikat fabric, which is sourced from a village called Kochampally, again in Telangana.
This is extremely useful for those people who believe in leather-free products. So this is really beautiful.
Absolutely. These are all eco-friendly products, and we make sure that even when you are a vegan, you can easily pick up one of our products and be very sure that no animal was harmed. So this is another one. This is a duffel bag, one of our best-selling products in our categories. It's made in a silk, which is sourced from the artisans of Gujarat. A very beautifully handcrafted, hand-blocked fabric, and one of our best-selling pieces. There's another signature style bag that we make. This is a combination of jute and textile put together to create something extremely elegant, goes beautifully with your work attire. A lot of women and girls, they love to carry it to work. It comes with a strap, so you can easily hold it on your shoulder. And it looks really smart with your Western wear, with your Indian wear. So it depends how you want to club it with. And one of the last purses that I'm going to show. This is another part of our signature style collection. And again, loved by a lot of working women. Simply because it's small, yet it has a lot of space and it sits beautifully on a table. And unlike other textile bags, these are not made in a jhola shape where they do not have a particular shape. So because of one thing that we all realize is once we go to corporate, we all love to pick up leather bag because they hold a shape nicely. And because we are a animal-friendly company, we want to make sure that we go by the same context of functionality, yet try to mix it up with traditional textiles. And I hope we are able to do it in certain manner.
We are amazing. Yeah.
Thank you. So another thing that we make is a beautiful jewelry form, which is called dokra. These are made by the artisans of Chhattisgarh and Odisha. And very elegantly done brass jewelry, and it goes beautiful with your sarees, with your kurti, even with your dresses. Your little black dress can always have a little bit of, you know, bling for your parties, for your evening get together.
I've been looking since long for something long and elegant for my saree and western top wear. This is something which I think is I should have for myself.
Absolutely. So another something extremely interesting that our artisan team and we did last year was around the Navratri, we came up with a Shakti collection. So if you see, you will see a Devi carved beautifully in this neck piece. So this was a great hit in our last collection. And I'm so proud how our artisans are able to create such beautiful, elegantly crafted pieces. And every time we create new collections, it's just beautiful to see how people are receiving these products so beautifully and so much with open arm. So yeah, these are some of the products that we've done in our last collection.
Okay, so these are some of the elegant pieces of your piece of artwork collections that we have seen so far. And there are many more, right? So if we want to go so we have some site or we have some Amazon collection that we can go, how we can go and look out for Chanchal.
Right. So our website is www.chanchal.co.in. That is our website, and we'll make sure that in the description we give the link. And we are also available on Amazon. So if you just look for Chanchal handbag or Chanchal dokra, you will find us under Amazon.in as well. And we are also there on Etsy. It's another international e-commerce platform. So you can find us there. And there are a lot of upcoming handcrafted e-commerce platforms like Unfactory, World Art Community, and so many others, where also we are part of these platforms, the Better India and the Little Black Book. So if you go to these websites, you can easily find us. And of course, we are there on Facebook, we are there on Instagram. All you have to do is just look for Chanchal Bringing Art to Life and you will find us.
So you're bringing art in a very amazing way, in a very eco-friendly and sustainable way. So kudos to you for doing that work. So
thank you.
So far, you have been into the handcrafted accessories. Now you're also moving into the sari section.
Right.
Right? So what's the idea behind moving from handbags, clutches, sunglasses, and accessories to now into the sari section?
So, as I said, Chanchal is all about promoting and reviving Indian textiles. And after doing so many accessories and realizing that people love Indian textile if they are given in the right format, we thought, why not try clothing? And sari is our attempt to do the same. We have created a collection of saris with our Bhagalpur weaving cluster. And what we have tried to do is weave the same traditional textile, but in a very contemporary way, which is something that will attract and would connect with a lot of independent working women. Because I realize that women love to experiment. And if you give them what they need or what they want, they would love to try that. So that's what we are doing with our new collection of sarees, and hopefully they will like it.
Yeah, and hopefully sari doesn't remain an occasional wear anymore.
Absolutely. The idea is to get the sari out of your closet and don't keep it for your occasions or for your festivals or just for the wedding. The idea is to break that myth that sari is just an occasion wear. We are trying to create saris which are great for every day, for office, for your drinks, for your coffees, for your evening parties. Wherever you can imagine to be, you can always try a different drape with a sari, and that's what we are trying to bring on the table.
Amazing. So Chanchal, this journey of you starting your own brand with the name Chanchal, I'm sure there has been a lot of phases. Sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not working. You experiment with a product, the response might not come immediately, but then after a while there is something amazing happening with the same product. Sometimes you must have felt, okay, this product is not working, but then there is a demand coming up. How has been this journey for you, and how do you define yourself throughout your journey, keeping yourself intact, composed, at peace, and ensuring that, yes, this is my baby, I have to nurture it no matter what?
You're right. Entrepreneurship is not easy. It's walking on a tightrope every single day. And unlike your corporate teams, there is nobody here to motivate you. So it has to be self-driven. There is absolutely nobody who would come and tell you what your dreams are, right? So it has to be totally dependent on how passionate you are. So one of the ways that I keep myself motivated is I keep myself reminding about the objective of Chanchal. Every time I feel a little low, I go back to seeing what I wrote in the initial times of Chanchal, where I defined my objective, where I clearly stated my vision, and I keep going back to that page even till now. Of course, there are days, they're good and bad, and you have to deal with it. Once you pick up a journey, there is no looking back, I would say. And you have to make your decisions every single day. And to keep yourself grounded, to keep yourself motivated, there has to be some support system that one needs. And I'm very fortunate that my family provides that perfect support system that one can imagine. And apart from that, I'm somebody who believes in the system of yoga, in meditation and in yoga on every single day. And that has been a practice even before when I started Chanchal. So I always go back to meditating. And when you disconnect from everything, that's when you know exactly what you want to do. And when you're able to breathe without taking any pressures, that really tells you what in the life you want to do. So moments like this, like these, they help me go back to what Chanchal is all about and why am I doing what I'm doing. And definitely, I think keep connecting to other people who have similar journeys as you. I love to talk to other entrepreneurs. I love listening to a lot of people on YouTube. We are in the time of technology. You can access so much of great information. So keep listening to some of the people who are doing great work. That helps. And meeting other entrepreneurs, talking to them about your journey, about your challenges, and basically trying to be positive all the time. Even when you are negative, it is okay sometimes to be in a frame of mind which is not positive. But the idea is not to get stuck to that. The idea is to come back. Okay. There will always be bad days, but not just in work. In everyday life, we face so many challenges. The idea is to keep coming back, to come back to life, to come back to the rhythm of life, and be ready to take on challenges, because unless we have challenges, there is no life. I mean, it will be so boring to be living same thing every day.
Monotonous life may be good, bad, however it is. So, Chanchal, we are almost close to the conclusion part. And one last question which I would like to have you is, this new version of yourself when you saw while starting Chanchal and being into that journey of scaling up, bringing up new products. So obviously, you started with one product, then you experimented with the another one, and then now you've moved on to a level where you are now bringing in sari, the new art in our life. Thank you for doing that. But Chanchal, what are the three lessons that you would like to share with us as an audience from your personal journey, which has been extremely unique for you?
I won't say they are unique to me, but these are the rules that I play by. And I'm sure like me, there are many others who are also probably going by the same rule. I think the first one is, there is no shortcut to hard work. You cannot replace hard work with anything else. Of course, you can work smartly, but even when you work smartly, there is the hard work involved. So yeah, be ready to work really hard. The second thing that I've learned is don't stop experimenting. Unless you tried, you won't know. And every single person has their own journey. So even when you are in a position to understand from others' learning, the same learnings cannot determine your actions or your plans, because unless you experiment, you wouldn't know what's going to work for you. And the third thing is, be grounded. Make sure you have a support system. Make sure you have people to talk to. No matter you are in a great position or you're in a bad position, it's extremely important to be grounded and to know where you belong to.
Wow, something really powerful. But yes, if one implements these few, even one of it, it just makes our journey better. So thank you, Chanchal. Thank you so much for bringing art in our life. And you've seen such beautiful range of products and you're scaling up to new heights. We have all our best wishes and all hearty congratulations for bringing it new pieces of art in our life. And we wish you good luck to move ahead of the ladder of this business journey of yours. May you bring in a diverse range of products in our life, which are eco-friendly, sustainable, and makes us more elegant.
Thank you so much. I need all the wishes. And I'm here hoping that everybody who's watching this little discussion of ours, and if they are planning to start their own entrepreneurial journey, I want to wish them good luck, of course, but I also want to say it's going to be an extremely enriching journey. If you are already on this path, or if you are planning to be on this path, rest assured you're going to learn so much about your own self. So all the very best. And feel free to get in touch with us if you think we can help you in any way.
Definitely. Thank you, Chanchal.
Thank you.